The disappointment of not being able to get the decision.
It's weird. It's a weird feeling because it's the first time in my life when I lost a decision, but I felt like I won. You know, I mean, I remember my last two losses. You know, against Mendoza or against Betis. I mean, I knew in that moment I lost. I was like, okay, this feels like shit, but I understand I lost, right? But this time I felt like, you know, like I won. But it is what it is, because it wasn't a really hard fight, you know? I mean, he had his own moments too, and I need to recognize that. I don't want to be that kind of guy who will start to put excuses, because I feel like Davison did an amazing job with a better game plan. So I just want to go to the gym. Just want to go to the gym, spend time with my family, and watch the fight again, and be back stronger.
Do you think it's fair to say you were more ready for the old days than the guy that maybe would fight out of control and load up on big shots and try to go after you, and maybe not so ready for the guy that was going to be, you know, kind of making you attack him and not being aggressive?
Maybe, you know, I was putting pressure on, definitely, and in some point he started to like go back and you know, suddenly exploding against me. I felt like he was throwing, like, you know, the power, but I was putting the volume there, and that's the thing. For example, in the first fight against him, it was the same. He was throwing like the power, and I was throwing the volume, and you never know what the judges put more attention in that point. So I don't know. Again, the fight was like 1 hour. 1 hour ago, so I need to go to my house, watch the fight, and, you know, be ready for the next one.
What was the reception like? You know, Dana White had said before the fight, he said, if Brandon won't become a star, he is a star, right? And when you walked out, it was so loud in there, and it seemed like everything you did, the crowd went crazy. What did that feel like?
Oh, man, the energy was amazing, you know? Going to the octagon this night, and watching all the Mexican flags, all the people around the arena, all the crowd and screaming my name, that feeling is incredible. And obviously I feel a little bit disappointed to don't put more emotions in the crowd that night. But, you know, it is what it is. I lost, and that hurts. And at the same time, I love when it hurts, because I can feel the pain, and, you know, that means to me, like, it's important to me to all be back. And, you know, it's crazy, because the door is so open for the fourth fight against this guy, and that's amazing, man. It's, you know, I just try to be very positive in my life, and I can see that possibility, and I start to make more history with this guy. It's crazy.
Yeah, you said the other day you were sick of him and you were ready to
it's crazy,
on.
Right?
So like, maybe you're not so sick of him right now, right?
No. I mean, I'm hungry than ever, and I wanna see this guy again. And this is the game. So I lost, and I mean, he lost last time, and it was like, oh, I wanna fight against Brandon Moreno. And me was like, oh, I don't wanna see you again, but let's go. And now it's like, no, I wanna see you again, man, you know? But I mean, I just want to go to the gym and work hard and put my manager to work.
Right. Speaking of that fourth fight, what did you make of Davidson saying he would be open to fighting you in Mexico?
Man, that's exciting, you know? I mean, obviously, you can say whatever you want, but at the end, when the UFC put the offer to you, and sometimes the guy starts to say no, and starts to put a lot of different conditions. So we'll see. I mean, that sounds amazing. I mean, there was a rumor there in social media who say like UFC wanted to go to the UFC, to Mexico City again, maybe June, maybe May. I mean, completely.
The broadcast was pointing out maybe later in the fight you weren't throwing as many combinations. Was that because Davidson maybe was hurting you, or were you just slowing down, or was it something specific that maybe Davidson did?
I feel like everything started to be like very strategic. You know, he was like going back, putting a lot of these, just waiting for me. And at the same time, I was like, you know, I can't be very, very aggressive because he's just waiting for me. You know, I just tried to do a little bit more feints, but he was like, I don't want to fight. I wanna go back. So yes, man, it was a little bit complicated. At the same time, you know, I need to recognize his new game plan was good too.
So at media day, you said you expected maybe a combination of the first two fights. Like the first fight, he was very aggressive. The second fight, maybe he was a little more calculated. Was that accurate in there?
Yes. Maybe not really, really aggressive, but I mean, just picking the exact moments to go up, to go forward. So that was nice for him.
Finally, did you speak to him or his team after the fight?
I just tried to be a gentleman with the team, you know, and go and hey man, congrats to the coaches, congrats. That guy, Eric, no man, you don't have my respect. But with Henry, I don't have any problem. Like saying, hey, thank you, good fight for everybody, and that's it.
Hey Brandon, right here. Can I ask why is there no respect with Coach Eric?
Ah, good man, of course. Drama, man, you know. You need to. I don't like drama in my life, so you can do your investigation. Just he did some things in my life where I don't respect. But again, with Henry, with all the team, the Brazilian coaches, I don't have any problems. So I went there and put my hand and shake hands. I like, hey, good job, guys.
At any point, you know, there was so much attention. You've heard it all week. Did it ever start to mess with your focus? Or was it ever just hard to be like, no, I just can't stay as hungry right now. Everyone, there's just so much energy around.
No, I felt like my mind was in the good place. Just was him doing a really good job with his game plan. You know, my mind was. I mean, the guys who are fighting against me, they need to understand. I don't care. I mean, if they try to do something against my mind, I don't care, man. That point is like, I'm very strong in that part of my. On my game, but I mean, again, I think the technical part was better.
Do you feel like this is a year where you can't take too much time off because there's so many guys at flyweight right now? There's a lot of guys who are obviously doing really well. Do you feel like there's pressure that you need to come back sooner rather than later?
Maybe, yeah. You know, the original plan, I was saying this in other interviews, but the original plan was like fight. You know, January, then fight maybe May, maybe June, and then yes. Fight in December, for example. You know, three fights in 1 year sounds good and sounds a good pace of fighting for me. So now I need to take to make a decision with my manager, with Jason, to see what happens in the future. But you know, I'm open to fight soon.
My last question,
sir.
You know, obviously you're doing well, but a lot of fans tonight, very sad that you lost. Do you have a message for the fans who are like, you know, it's a tough night?
Yes, you know, it's life. This is the life. And again, I mean, right now I'm just trying to be like very positive and I'm trying to put my face with you guys. But definitely hurts, man. It hurts too much. I wanted to put the victory for my family, for my teammates, for Mexico, for, you know, for my fans. But this is life, and it is what it is. I lost, and sometimes you lost, man. I lost before, and I'm alive, and I'm here, and I just try to feel the taste of the loss and go back to the gym. That's it.
Brandon, far right over here. This is an amazing fight, my friend. When you were out of the UFC, I was at your LFA fight in person. And I said, I know this guy's coming back. You always seem to be able to recreate yourself and make yourself better. And you're only 28 years old. You're a champion, and you just have the world, I think, is still yours to own. And the championship is still yours to get. You're welcome. Question, in this fight, did you feel anything different from Davidson? I know Henry Cejudo was helping him to make his grappling better. You dominated the grappling last time. I know it was a really close fight. I'm not trying to make you say he did this so good or not so good, but was there something a little different, and if so, what would that be?
Yeah, I mean, again, I feel like he was like more calculated in his attack, better distance, definitely. he tries to, in maybe in the first and second round, trying to take me down, but I felt like I did a really nice job. Maybe four rounds, I don't exactly, right now I don't remember well, but he take me down because I closed the distance too much. But I get back like very, very quickly. But nothing, man. I mean, right now it's hard to answer that because I need to watch the fight again and see my mistakes, because definitely I made mistakes in that fight. But again, it's weird because I felt like I did the enough to win the battle. I know he connect me pretty hard, but I connect better with better, precision, with a lot of precision. But, you know, judges, at the end of the day, I lost and I need to go to the gym.
Right, absolutely. I know you're not the matchmaker. We have Vic and Sean, but if you were the matchmaker, would you say that Brandon Moreno gets this next fight, or that only fair, maybe one other person gets this next fight and then you're after that?
Man, I need to push very hard, you know, with the company and with my manager, with Jason, to go for the 4-1 against Figueiredo. We need to be very smart too, in the point, you know, to go. And hey, man, I mean, the last fight was amazing. The last three fights were amazing, right? So I feel like I have enough arguments to push the fight, and you know, just keeping making history. You know, the first time, two guys fighting four times.
That'd be fantastic. It was an amazing fight. You're a superstar, and it's so awesome that you came out here and talked to us. Big respect to you, man.
Thank you so much.
Decías que quieres la cuarta pelea, y en 13 meses se han enfrentado ya en tres ocasiones. ¿Qué hace tan especial esta rivalidad entre tú y Davis?
Híjole, no sé, creo que algo tenemos. Creo que son ese tipo de rivalidades, Barrera Márquez, ese tipo de cosas, ¿no? Que eventualmente tuviste que pelear con él muchas veces para demostrar quién era el mejor. La primera fue empate, la segunda gané, la tercera él ganó. Vamos por la cuarta y vamos a ver qué pasa, ¿no? O sea, ¿qué lo hace especial? Supongo que es el hecho de que pues ya compartimos demasiado el octágono, ¿no? Ya más o menos nos conocemos, ya más o menos sabemos qué es lo que nos afecta un poquito. Y nada, o sea, esta pelea estuvo bien cerrada, se pudo ir para cualquiera, los jueces decidieron que era para Davison. Lo acepto como hombre completamente la decisión y nada, no quiero poner excusas, solo quiero regresar al gimnasio y ver qué pasó y ganar experiencia y para frente.
Parecía lógico que si ganabas defendieras en México, pero te sorprendió que él diga que quiere pelear en México la cuarta.
Suena chido, supongo que pues, estamos. Imagínate, o sea, una revancha en México creo que vendería muchísimo y pues eso le generaría muchísimo dinero a Davison. Creo que es una oportunidad grande para él. Entonces, yo súper puesto. O esperemos que ese rumor de que UFC quiere volver a junio, o sea, crezca y ya deje de ser un rumor, que sea oficial. Y yo estoy dentro de pelear ahí.
Brandon, por acá. Brandon, ¿qué te parece que aún en la derrota todavía la afición mexicana te seguía apoyando? ¿En ningún momento te dejaron de apoyar? ¿Cómo lo sentiste?
No manches, o sea, lo aprecio muchísimo. Y es lo que a lo mejor a veces como que el inglés no me alcanza, pero pues me duele mucho, ¿no? Me duele, o sea, yo trato de venir aquí y ser un hombre y poner mi cara con todos ustedes, pero me duele. Me duele muchísimo el no haber podido regalarle la victoria a la afición mexicana. Lo quiero decir así porque había, yo creo que muchísima gente apoyándome, pues, mexicana, ¿no? Y eso me duele. Es que lo único que puedo prometer ahorita es que voy a volver. Y lo he hecho, o sea, eso sí lo puede ver la gente. Eso sí creo que lo he demostrado, ¿no? Que me he caído y me he levantado fuerte y mejor que nunca. Entonces, pues nada, solamente el tiempo dirá, pero pues estoy listo para los retos que vengan enfrente.
Gracias.
No, eso.
Brian, over here to your left, mate.
Left. How
you doing?
Left.
Yeah, yeah. I think we're going to be seeing that spinning leg kick across gyms all around the world next week. And I was just wondering, was there a technical reason for throwing that with me, just being creative?
I'm a ninja. Man, you know, sometimes I always say the same. So when you are close to the fight, it's like sparring, like nothing crazy, like go and do your job, right? But when I'm out of competition, I love to do something crazy, just to try. So what happened? And I worked so hard in that kick in this last training camp, so I feel the confidence to throw it. And I couldn't, man, I throw like four kicks and I couldn't three. It's like, that's perfect.
It's good. Well done, bro.
Thank you, man.
Brandon, the flyweight division was sort of, it was created for the most part by Demetrius Johnson. That's when you came to the UFC, and Henry Cejudo likes to say that he saved the flyweight division. But why is it that you have been able to connect with the fans and the audience more to elevate this division to the point where no one could ever consider that the UFC would ever get rid of flyweights again?
Because I understand I have this personality who you can connect with the people. I always say the same. So, for example, careers like Khabib is like, oh, this guy is incredible. He's undefeated. He's 29-0 and he retires. He's incredible. He's our god, right? But I feel like my histories, the people can connect more with my history. Like, it's more human, right? Like, the guy lost and the guy win and the guy go back to the gym and go back to the octagon and win again. So I feel like I can connect more with the people for that. And man, I'm just starting to be real. I mean, the people in the street can watch the same guy in the octagon than the street easily. So that's it, man. I think is that I'm just trying to be real every single day in my life, and the people can see that.
Pues. Brandon, de este lado, ¿cómo está, señor?
¿Qué tal, señor?
Ya habías anticipado que esperabas un Davison totalmente distinto. ¿Era justo lo que encontraste o era parecido a lo que esperabas y algo que no hayas alcanzado a descifrar?
Mira, me sorprendió el hecho de que esperó demasiado y a lo mejor eso yo no lo pude descifrar. O sea, yo sentí que en cierto punto el nada me estaba esperando, que yo entrara para o patear o buscar el contragolpe, y eso creo que eso no lo pude resolver. Eso creo que fue mi error, porque también estaba afuera y yo estaba bien consciente, ¿no?, de que me está esperando. O sea, se siente raro, lo vuelvo a repetir, lo dije en inglés, pero o sea, me gustó, quiero decirlo en español porque obviamente me fluye más. con Pettis, con Pantoya, o sea, yo cuando llegué a que el referee me agarrara la mano para que diera la decisión, yo sabía que me había perdido. O sea, yo dije, no, o sea, nada, cállate la boca y regresa al gimnasio y puedo entrenar. En esta, pues fue muy cerrada y yo siento que tengo los argumentos para decir que yo gané. Pero, de nuevo, no quiero ser ese tipo de las excusas, no quiero ser el tipo de que esto y el otro y fue la culpa del juez. No, jamás. Quiero volver al gimnasio, quiero regresar fuerte, quiero enfocarme y seguir adelante en mi carrera.
Dos preguntas en uno. Al finalizar el tercer asalto hay un knockdown y te intentó someter unos cuantos segundos. ¿Qué tan herido estabas que te hubiera podido someter si hubiera habido 20, 30 segundos más?
No, para nada, porque ya tenía las manos estiradas. Creo que eso sí estoy muy consciente de eso. Creo que caí, el tipo se me lanzó al cuello y yo estiré las manos controlando las caderas. Iba a ser muy difícil que él pudiera brincar a la guardia por eso. Entonces, pues, no había peligro. Creo que me considero una persona muy buena defendiendo la guillotina. Entonces, no sentí realmente el peligro en ese momento.
Gracias.
Por acá, Brandon. Acá atrás. ¿Qué tal? Buenas noches. Ya lo explicaste en inglés, ¿no? Lo de los argumentos por los cuales tú te mereces esa cuarta pelea. Si nos puedes decir en español, primero, ¿por qué Brandon Moreno se merece esa cuarta pelea ante Davison Figueiredo?
Mira, es que creo que empezando por la historia, ¿no? De los intensos que han estado los combates desde el primero hasta este último, pues el segundo fue muy dominante de mi parte, el tercero fue una guerra completamente, donde por ahí de repente sí como que estábamos muy calculadores y no nos animábamos a soltar las manos, pero de repente empezábamos a soltar las bombas. Creo que eso estuvo muy bueno. Creo que por eso y porque hasta cierto punto pues queda inconcluso, ¿no? Queda inconcluso, la primera se queda como descartada porque fue empate, entonces yo gané una, él ganó otra. La cuarta suena muy muy lógica y suena chido para la historia de la división, para la historia de la compañía inclusive, porque será la primera vez que dos atletas se enfrentan por cuarta vez.
Por último, de mi parte, habías comentado en una de las entrevistas que te hizo falta poder ¿A qué crees que se debió eso? ¿Algo en la preparación? ¿Por qué crees que sucedió?
Mira, no, yo voy a ser muy honesto contigo. Sé que no soy ese peleador de poder. Yo no pego fuerte. Quisiera, me encantaría. Y trabajo todos los días en el gimnasio para tener una pegada sólida. Y quiero decirte que mi cara se ve muy bien a comparación. Pero sí comprendo que pues él tiene pegada y tiene pegada dura, y yo conecté muchísimo más, pero él cada vez que a lo mejor conectaba fuerte me movía, y eso es impresionante para los jueces. De ahí parte mi argumento, que a lo mejor, que no sé, o sea, quisiera saber qué es lo que un juez aprecia muchísimo más, o sea, el conectar fuerte o el conectar mal. Es el rollo, pero pues nada, creo que al final del día estoy divagando y pues quiero ver la pelea, ¿no? Para ver exactamente qué pasó.
Muchas gracias.
Vale. That's it? No, one more.
Brent, did you have a chance to talk to him after the fight in the back?
No. I mean, you know, I was trying to be very professional inside the octagon, like, hey man, congrats to the team. And that's it. I don't see him in the backstage or something like that.
If you do have a fourth fight, as history has never happened in the UFC, what can we expect different in the fourth fight than the first three?
The only you can expect, I'll go to the gym, I'll pull my computer, watch the fight, and see what happened in this one.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Guys, thank you so much. I'm pretty hungry. I can eat pizza right now. So see you.